Hello and thanks again for joining me. The idea of today's lesson came about due to a documentary I saw on polar bears. Their humour and majesty really inspired me. And inspiration is such a magical thing, it can come from almost anywhere. So that's why today I'll be creating a sculpture of a polar bear. So let's see if we can successfully capture this fine creature's character. So I'll be using the Mont Marte air hardening white clay for my bear. Regarding tools, I'll be using the Mont Marte clay tool set and the mini modelling tools. For a work surface, I'll be using the Easy Clean palette. Yes, I know it's a painting palette, but as a sculptural working base, it's fantastic. It's non-porous and you can spin the sculpture to view it at different angles. And while I think of it, we have a sculptural introduction lesson on Mont Marte TV that you might like to have a look at. Well, let's get into it. So the first step is to tape my reference drawings on the wall in front of where I'm sculpting. And take out my clay. So our first step is to create the base. And we'll be using a whole block of clay and we'll be cutting it in half with the fettling knife. The trick here is to make the cut directly in the middle of the block. It's time now to create the legs. So lay up the other half of your block and cut 4 equal size proportions. Cut them about that big. Here's a good tip. When you're not using your clay, always put it in an airtight container. So roll each of these into a cylinder. You don't need to be precise at this stage. Roughly round is good. So let's create our back leg first. So take your cylinder and just bend a foot shape into the end. And that's our first back foot. Place these into position. This initial placement is important to get right, so our polar bear's gait looks convincing. Now for the two front legs. This one and this one, obviously. And they're quite easy. Just bend his little foot into it like that. And then place into position like the other two. So one of the things that we must keep doing when we are creating a sculpture is look at our reference drawings. And I'm going to put this last front leg in. And I can see from the drawings here that these feet are actually touching and this one is a little bit in front. So create your foot and then lay that into position. Now we have our legs roughly in position. We're going to put our reinforcement armatures in. And we're going to use toothpicks to do that. So pick up your base and push in the toothpicks. And you want them to go up through the middle of each leg. Let us now make the body. So I've opened a new block of clay. And as I observe my reference drawings, I noticed that the body is pretty much a teardrop shape, so let's make that. Tear the block into two parts, then fashion one part into a teardrop. Use the round-ended tool to smooth and shape as you go. So one of the things to remember with his body is to just try and get that big round bum right. Once the shape is smooth, you can manipulate it with your hands. You'll notice that I haven't finished the head, but I have put a stump in there. That will dry a little bit and act as an armature for when we create the head a little bit later. So let's put this body on. To do that, I'm snipping the inside of each leg at an angle. So moisten the cuts with a little bit of water or slip. Push the clay together and then place your body on. Manipulate the body until you are happy with how he sits. Keep referring to the reference drawings, and when you are happy with the positioning, you can smooth the legs in with cover strips of clay. As well as creating a smooth join, the additional clay is adding skeletal and muscle tone suggestion. Do this on all the legs and build up the level until you're happy with its profile. As you do this, keep rotating the sculpture to see it looks right at every angle. It's a good idea to slowly build up the clay, as it is a hassle to remove cleanly. Once the legs are roughed in, I place another toothpick in to support the neck at the right position. Well, that's the body laid on. Now we switch our attention to the legs and give them muscle tone and form. This is just an exercising in adding, subtracting, and refining from observation. Just smooth as you go. It's also at this stage that you decide how much detail to put in and at what level you stylize the bear's legs. I'm using the fettling knife to remove a large chunk of clay here. There, that's more like it. Well, that's nice and smooth. I really like how this is taking shape. I'm getting quite excited. As I look at my sculpture, I notice that he's missing those lumpy shoulder blades, or scapulars, in here. So let's create a couple of them. Suggesting the occurrence of bone mass is quite important to convey the impression of weight on a subject. We're talking about a creature that on average weighs 400 kilos. So let's create a head for our friend. As I look at my reference drawings, I notice a few things. The snout is quite square. There's also a flat area on top of the head, and there's a fair bit of fat deposited around our friend's neck. So let's focus on these important features. Tear off a portion of nice soft clay and wrap it around the neck stump. Make sure there is no air between the new clay and the stump. This can create shrinkage problems in the drying stage. Then just start to manipulate the clay into a head shape. To be honest, there is no trick here. It's just trial and error, close observation of the reference drawing, and persevering until you are happy with the bear's character. Remember as well, you don't have to finish the bear in one sitting. You can wrap it in cling wrap and come back to it with fresh eyes. I have created three balls. One for the tail, and these two are for the ears. So let's just plonk them on and smooth them in. The thing to remember here is ears are quite a fair way back on a bear's head. Let's attach his cute little tail now too. And then just smooth it in. I can now refine all the detail on the head and create those folds in the ears. Finally, the eyes, nostrils, and the mouth. And these can all be done with the sharp triangular modelling tool. This stage looks really easy, but many sculptures have been spoiled from, say, a bad nostril or eye placement. Ta-da! Let that dry, and you've got yourself a fantastic little polar bear sculpture. Well, how much fun was that? I think that I'm going to create two cute little cubs to go with him. So give this fantastic medium a try. And until next time, keep on creating art.